Hello, everybody. We are with our witch hunter just about to start the next day. We are acceptably rich. We have plenty of wordstone, which I will send off right away as soon as we get a shipment request. But for now, we're just going for the next mission. The only thing I quickly adjusted is upgraded with a few of our guys. The armor, for example, Adalwulf now got a purple cloth armor, and Clyde, he got a different axe with an enchantment on there for maxing out damage. I think I equipped him as well with a purple one over here, but nothing too fancy. We complete, I think, last time the side objective, so now it's time for something more appropriate for us. And let's be honest, the rating over here in this Crush the Will is much better, especially looking at the exceptional loot, but this is deadly. And that's what I want. I go for deadly, because I like deadly. I really, at some point, would like to switch Dumph back into the game. But I cannot see how we should let go on these two. And Aldris, I just want to be alone. Maybe at some point, Aldris goes out and will take these two along. Peter and Dumph. But for the time being, I'm happy with the setup. I might switch around Konrad? No, Karl. And Argus gets in, so he gets a little bit of experience. Dietmar goes in for Felton. And at least like this, we get a little bit of the experience point for these guys. So let's go ahead and see what we have to face.
Your scouts have discovered a rival warband in the vicinity. These warriors are clustered around their wagon, making them a very attractive target.
So we are facing the undead. The undead are not fun to face, let's put it that way. And we need to take out Pavel and Ovidiu and take their mementos. They are clustered around their wagon is what the description said, so they all are going to be on the complete other side of the map. That's perfectly fine. Because I again hope for plenty of zombies, which will be, of course, therefore a little bit behind, thanks to their lack of speed. And we can focus completely on the impressive, if this one manages to get towards us, as well as on the vampires that most certainly will get to us. I think that's an acceptable idea. But yeah, as I said, we have to take a look first how fast this is proceeding. And by the looks of it, it might be that there are quite some ghouls around. That's also fine. I think most important is for us to take out the impressive. And engage with Clyde as well as Dietmar now. And Reichwald, the vampires, because these guys that I just mentioned are immune to psychological effects. Aldaris, he is going for the enemy's impressive. I'm pretty sure that he stands a very good chance there. And of course, Adalwulf will shoot at whatever is coming across his way. I think I will move over here. And yeah, take this trap long and take the fight to that location. Maybe we get at a proper position that's a little bit up so we can get the bonus. And something I have not noticed till just now, there's a demon around. The map actually is smaller than I expected. Within this movement, actually, it might be that we get our first line of sight. Since we didn't have line of sight on the demon, I assume that he's in this area. Maybe even around here. Well, could become tricky. If this guy or girl, whatever it is, this thing, decides to go for us, We might be into some kind of trouble. Especially if that falls exactly into that time, and that's how it would be, at which we are engaging these guys. I Okay, we have our first zombie right in front of us. Not our target, so let's just kill him. Killing him? No problem, because all of you guys know nowadays, they are not worth any kind of morale. And that's perfect. Gives us the option of just running there and killing them and focus right afterwards on everybody else that is more important to us. At least that's the plan. As we know from our experience, these plans do not necessarily work that way. But yeah, we'll see. I'm always up for a nice challenge. Same would count if you are interested in a PvP game. Just let me know. I'm always up for challenge. You know which kind of warbands I have. You know how they fight, almost. Maybe it's a little bit different when I play against the human player. Most likely it is. But yeah, just add me on Steam. It's Bardrick52, I think. Or write me on YouTube, that's also fine. Let me know what's your name and I'll add you over there. I'm fine if it's a friendly match. So, no experience, no anything there. I'm also fine if it's worth something. So basically you get experience points as well as the rewards later on, and the injuries are actually permanent as well there. Well, be that as it may, now we are here at that point, and we first have to take care of these guys. Which are proceeding very strangely, because why is the zombie already around here? Michal, why are you here all by yourself? He's moving extremely fast. I'm actually a little bit surprised by that, but also pretty happy because he will move even before Alderus, and he will make his way towards us, so we can charge him, kill him.
A new round.
Happy
has
days.
Started.
Happy time. Oh, I found something. Or he found me. He's not our target either. But we know that Grigor is right around the corner over there. Maybe I need to adjust my plans there for a little bit, but this shot goes out for sure. There's another guy, I cannot really recognize what it is. Necromancer maybe, with two-handed weapon? Whatever it is, he's there waiting for us as well. Maybe I'll take a few more shots at Michal, just to make sure that he's dying this round already. Yeah, sure. Let's get another shot out. I think the positioning over here is pretty good. I'll stay over here. No shooting available, but we can dodge. A little bit surprised that the Impressive is not our target. Yeah, it's a Necromancer. With just two enemies that we have to take out, I would have expected him to be one of these. Again, I don't care, but... yeah, well, we have to find now who is our target, so... yeah, that's painful for him, sorry. Not so painful for us. Especially considering that we can heal ourselves up. Oh, that's... I'm almost sorry for him. Yeah, bye-bye. You shouldn't mess around with Alderus. Also, this zombie... oh yeah, this zombie is our target. Happy times. Here, there we have this guy standing. Do I want to take the ambush? He's most likely in ambush stance, right? Actually, I could simply engage him, and I will do so. Why not? Might not because he will counter-take everything we do, but that's fine. No, it's not fine if we are missing. It's especially not fine if he's dealing lots of damage. That's still acceptable at that point of time, because we can heal ourselves up. And I would like him to do less. That's the exact amount that I like. Yeah, one more attack and then we go into sidestep. This guy is slightly crippled. His leg, his arm. I can't complain about that, or I won't complain about that. It's his dodging though that is increased by that, at least by the arm. That might make it a little bit more difficult to hit him. But who cares, right? As I like to state that rather often, we will be fine. Joseph, he's coming in as well. Charging against our Impressive. Luckily he's missing the charge because I really would like to have the dodge ready for the Impressive. Ovidiu, I'm fine with if he comes a little bit closer to us. Where are you going? I'm over here. Ah, these zombies. I know there's words thrown all over the place, but I'd rather take a look at the loot that we can get. Not from him. Because you've seen it maybe you've paid attention to that. We have a lot, and that's really a lot of blue weapons and equipment. And I don't like that. We should be at a point where we get actually quite good purple one. Oh, we have spotted the Chaos Ogre. I'm not happy with this positioning, even though I almost was sure about the positioning over there. I'm not happy because when he moves, he will most likely go for our guys. The exception might be I didn't take it. Okay, I just looked at it. The exception might be when the Necromancer, or whoever is still close enough, will come towards us and is getting between his path and my units. If that is not going to be the case, Reichwald will have to take care of that, and therefore I will not move him further than that. I hate it that Reichwald is so extremely slow. Does he have knowledge of more time? I'm absolutely not sure. You move a little bit further. Move further. Move further, my friend. Well, he's in ambush stance. That might help us a lot. Also, Clyde will for now stay right here. Why does the ambush help us? If the Chaos Ogre gets too close, he will. Again, we got a trap here. He will charge against him. And hopefully. I really want the healing hand on Aldous. That's not happening. And hopefully, that's going to happen that way. We're just ending our turn here, that's fine. He might intercept it. It's getting a very close call, though. Argus. I almost would assume that one or two enemies are coming from this side. So please stand ready over here.
A new round has started.
A little bit of fire on the big guy. That's fine. That's actually very fine. I would like him to miss, though, not only dodging from our side. Perfect. This one is getting dodged as well, and that might have been his last attack. Nope, one more. Aldaris is acceptable level of health. Acceptable only, though. I hope that Matthias does not get engaged by anyone, and we can just go around and heal him. Therefore, of course, the Necromancer needs to attack someone, and that is, best case scenario, the Chaos Ogre. next zombie approaching. Theodore it is. We have line of sight on one of the targets of ours. The other one, probably still hiding here. I would assume it's the leader that we have to face, but we'll see that in a bit. After hitting Yanku a few times. I'm just going to shoot now regular shots at him. And I'm not sure if that's the smartest idea. If he is getting engaged with the Chaos Orc, I would like him to be engaged as long as possible. You know what? I'm going to delay. If we get engaged by Chaos Orc, I will shoot at him with a crippling shot and hope that he will get affected by that somehow. Now what's he doing? That was expected, this movement. That's actually... That looks good. That looks bad. That's annoying. He would have gone for the Necromancer. And he didn't even go into ambush stance. And we are missing over here that I hate a lot. Let's throw this thing in because the Necromancer might have the idea of getting there. Attacking this thing instead of us. Also, it's probably blocking his ambush. What is happening over here is a little bit annoying because I need to deal a little bit of damage, at least a little bit. But we missed three times. And this is only fine because we can heal. Okay, just take another regular shot at him. We can reload and dodge. There we go. Now, big question, what is he doing? Hold ground, that's okay. Well, he tried to move and is getting charged by Conrad. Not the worst thing, but by far not the best. The best would have been, engagement would be, Chaos Ogre. He's still worrying me a little bit, I have to admit that. I think we've spotted a second Necromancer over there even. Well, bring support in here. That sounds like a good idea. If we take him out, we can move our units freely again. Let's be honest, whoever is facing the Chaos Ogre will have to deal a lot of damage, and most likely I have to engage with our Impressive. Who is very, very busy. This video is a little bit stupid, right? Or is it just me? We are losing already our first dodge on this side. It's not the best. I'm placing him over here to have a little bit of protection for Matthias. Who hopefully will do something efficient with the healing for Alderus. Strong blow works out as well, and it doesn't look good for Yanku, who still has to do the all alone test. If he fails that two free attacks, he's most likely dead. If nobody else is going to engage. Yeah, I would like to bring Reichwald as support for Alderus. Therefore, I need to make this freaking way around here though. Who are you? You're the leader. You're not our target. Oh, this Necromancer is our second target. Okay. No, you know what? Reichwald is not getting there into the fight right now. Not with the leader being around the corner. Wait over here in Web of Steel. Next round, we are engaging him somewhere. Clyde, on the other hand, he will find an engagement. I think it might be not the worst idea to take charge on him. starting to damage him. His counterattack will not be worth that much. And I think that Clyde, even without a defense stance, is going to be fine. Not if we are missing. A hit would have been best. Well, that's okay. Unfortunately, Clyde only has one attack now. But yeah, that's sometimes how it is. Nope, not Fritz. He needs some healing. 80 health, that is actually, as said already before, really, really good. We get devotion, I don't know what that does. Plus 2 OP cost for casting. That's slightly annoying. 2 heals would have been the best, but yeah, that's life. Wait, I'm attacking the right Ovidio, am I? It's Ovidio, the zombie that has to die. And that's extremely annoying because this Ovidio is doing a lot of damage. Over here, the Necromancer does not have to do the all-alone test at the time. That's not going to work that way. I don't want him to be able to attack, so we have to take him out. Also for the sake of our little flagellant. Who needs a few heals?
A new round.
And we're going to waste most of our healing on him. We are dodging every attack that is coming in. Unfortunately, we do not have the mastered version of it. And probably now the incoming round, or the actually it's a current round, the Chaos Ogre will decide to go for us. Yeah, I don't like that. But 14 damage is more than acceptable. It might have been a mistake to not get over here with Reichweite. He has a lot of attacks, I don't like that. Also, small bites make over time a painful experience for us. You get 100% shot at the pyre of ours. I don't want that, I want to shoot at him though. I think it's time that he's losing some health. And especially that he's losing some of his attack points. We have one more shot ready. We don't need the crippling shot though. And this one is missing. 95% chance and a miss. Can't say... Okay, can't even point out proper how disappointed I am in this. I have the feeling that I might have rushed a little bit too far ahead with our guys. It might have been the better choice to let them come one more round towards us. Chaos Ogre stuck. I cannot say that I'm unpleased by that. I would like to deal here some damage. Alderis, your last performance was a disappointment. And it doesn't look like this one is much better. Also, the Spore one is very annoying because he's taking away our dodges. Maybe I should focus on him first. Francie on Ovidio, but Clyde should be fine. Now this round he will get his defense stances and with that should have no problem. That was expected. Not much I could have done about that. Well, I couldn't have engaged him. I could have not engaged him, so there we go. Yeah, but that's not how our gameplay works. I would like to get to a point that our friend over here doesn't have to do all around tests, so I'm going around here and engage with the Necromancer because he's our target. Yeah, Yeah, let's hope that Dietmar, I think his name was Dietmar, I don't even know his proper. I'm not sure even if Dietmar is the right name. Yeah, well, for now he's called Dietmar. I don't even know if... Oh, I just hope that he's going to be fine. That's what I want to say. He didn't join us in that many fights, so it would be a shame to lose him in the first one that he's allowed to join. I will make quick focus on our target, guys. And afterwards support our impressive. Or I said, since I do not know where the leader went now, if he, oh, he didn't move so far, I will engage as well with Reichweite. I think I want to charge in, so I have... No, it's totally fine like that. Really? Charging in would have been useful if I would not have had the Web of Steel afterwards, but I do, so I'm fine with just walking in. But somehow, also Reichwald sucks terribly at hitting. We can parry three times, that should help Alderaas as well. Over here, Ovidio should go down rather quickly. Scratch that, he will be fine for the next 50,000 years. I wonder if I, normally, theoretically, if I'm healing these guys, they should take damage. Yeah. But my heals don't work anyhow. And I think it's just a theory. It will not be the case over here. You know what? I'm leaving these here by themselves for now and will quickly support over here. Our casting sucks bad time thanks to the increased costs. And also I think like this we have a better chance of the Chaos Ogre if he decides to move to go for the enemy. Or maybe our pyre. Still focus please on Pavel. And with these guys down, afterwards I will just smash everything that's around. That's perfectly fine.
A new round has started.
Yep, that is what I was hoping for. That Reichwald is getting focused, or at least is getting one or two of these attacks. We have a dodge over there. Then a miss. That's how I like to see it. Maybe one more on Reichwald. Or no attack at all. That's perfectly fine. That's a shame. That's annoying. And our guys don't care. Don't try that again. Well, he will. He has four attacks, I think. Second one is miss. Third one is dealing a little bit of damage against Fritz. Yeah, he's just wielding a dagger, so... What is all this fuss about? Just drop dead. Like your friends. Be part of their group. No, you should have parried that. Only 32% chance, but you should have parried that. Let's take a few more shots at this guy. I'm afraid that he will still get some kind of impact here. And at that point, I want him to be low on health. Well, it will take quite some time. I could shoot also at the other units, but... Let's be honest, that's okay. I normally should have sidestepped with him, right? And I never use it now. Is he going for Reichwald as well? No, he's still not doing anything. So, he tried to get to us. No, no, no. No, 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 no. The other one's a much more attractive target, my friend. Even if that is doing nothing, it will block him. And I'm fine with that. At least until Grigor is down. And this one is a very good round for that. Aldaris is doing a good job. This round, I'm very happy. No crit, but a few fire perch. I think it was two or maybe three of these. That helps as well. And we still have Reichwald engaged over there. We'll take care of the rest. Nice dodge on both sides here. Unfortunately, that sucked. That sucked badly. But at least he's failing his dodge. If these guys don't start doing proper damage, Matthias and Clyde will be even faster than they are. But yeah, to be fair, Matthias and Clyde are really, really good damage dealer. Over here, if Reichwald decides to hit, I don't know why he only has 67% hit chance, but if he decides to proper hit, Grigor is down. Actually, one hit is sufficient, thanks to the fire perch. And this hit has to go out. There we go. He is down to 11 health. The fire does around 14 damage, I think. That's not much. I actually think it's not enough. But that's okay. And I'm happy with Grigor going down anyhow, so it's perfect fun. Same counts for Ovidio, who will be knocked out by Matthias. That will give us our first objective item. I could also go for a heal on someone, but I think we are fine for the current time being. I'm not sure if the Chaos Ogre actually is engaged with the Ghoul. I don't think so.
Objective completed. Objectives updated.
And I only think he's not because he did not attack. We have one heal ready. No, I think the heal should go out on him. Well, it should go out. I said it should go out. Yeah, make a little bit of light and then hide over here in shame. Nice dodge on this part. Well, so much for the engagement of this guy. This could have been the death of Argus, and I would have blamed Matthias for this. Really? Really? Really?
A new round has started.
What the fuck was that? How could he have possibly ran away there? Why the heck did they get free attacks? This is annoying. This was absolutely unnecessary, and of course I'm blaming Matthias. Failing at 80% cast chance. This, I mean, two crits, okay. Fair enough, that was a lot of damage, but he could have survived that. I would need to look back now and make the math if he would have done that. But no, Matthias is to be blamed, so easy it is. Matthias and game mechanic. Mostly Matthias, though. And now let's focus on the game and not get too annoyed. We killed, as said, the ghoul. No, the crypt, yeah, crypt ghoul. That's perfectly fine. It's not so fine that this guy is dealing that much damage. Four attacks, we can heal that up. We can, in theory, if Matthias decides not to suck that bad. Really? He's not engaging the enemy. He's very, very much in favor of the undead, apparently. Aldaris has to quickly knock out Joseph, and then we can proceed over here. I think I should not kill him. So, well, it's fine. They have enough morale left afterwards. But anyhow, it doesn't happen this round, so it's doesn't matter. Okay, this guy has to die this round so we can continue and end the fight. This was Argus? Was it Argus? Yeah, I think it was Argus. Getting knocked out like that is just annoying. Okay, take care of him. 22 morale, that's perfectly fine. Just need to go ahead and collect his token. Maybe Matthias will do something proper and, well, do this for us. Or Reichwald, if he gets around here. Yes, he does. I'm not engaging with the ghoul, that is a little bit overkill. We'll take this. Take the words on as well. Completed. We might need to hire a new guy. And now, can I ambush? Yeah, ambush, of course. I want to charge, though. Because of having Web of Steel ready afterwards. This video was a pain. He will get attacked. Also, he is costing the enemy, or his loss will cost the enemy morale. So that's a good choice, I guess. I think the best part of it will be that we are going to block all of his attacks. Which is two. Which is too much, especially considering the damage that he dealt. Clyde, he will help over here, since he does not have to do the fear test. Also, killing Philip would end the match. Well done. And sidestep might become crucial for him as well. Matthias, what about you are not being a cock and you start healing your units? Thanks. I should be so grateful. Oh, and there we go. Gratefulness stopped again. Again, you're a cunt. Look at you. This guy taking a little bit of damage. He's no threat anymore. He never was a threat, he was just a pain in my ass. Really? 4% chance for a crit. And we fail the block. Let's start with it. We fail the block.
A new round.
I wanna see
started.
These numbers. Parry fail. 67% chance we failed that one. Let's start with this. Then this guy has a 4% crit chance, which he succeeds. Fair enough. Might happen sometimes. Then we get stunned. I didn't check on the stun resistance of ours. 24%. Nah. This round is just not in our favor. The game is trying hard to screw with us. Chaos Ogre only focusing on us. Argus being for some reason knocked out. Okay, Dietmar I can accept. Then these stunts over there and not fun. Yeah, steal my stuff. At least he's not going for our Reichweite. He's not going for anyone. He's trying to run away with the loot that he just stole. Dodge. At least this one is still working. Well, the parry, obviously not. And another crit, but this time we are still standing. And? Really? He's sneaking around the enemies of ours, trying to get to us. What's wrong with him? Screw you. And I will continue with this now. Killing him. Whom did he want to attack over there? This Chaos Ogre is nuts! Fritz has to do an all along fear test, so I will engage over here. Hopefully killing Ovidio, which he really deserves. With that, they are on the routing test level. Which they will pass, there's no doubt about that. Why should they fail? Yeah, stay over here, that's fine. You'll see next round, if there's next round, where we have to go. Now we're failing the terror test, that is what I expected already in the beginning. Counterattack maybe? Which kills us. Okay, we are taking care of Philip. Philip has to die, and then it's fine, then we're happy. Again, I don't think that the Chaos Ogre is in any kind of ambush stance, which will lead me to the point that I should still heal. Maybe twice this time, because otherwise, if we are not finishing this round... really, Matthias, why are you so bad? Why are you just bad? If they pass the test, they might kill us. And with Asamio, of course, only him here, Fritz, or whoever it is. Thanks to the crit that we got, we have reduced hit chance. We have three attacks if all of them are hitting. Philip von Drag will be dead, and that would be it, of course, again. But yeah, why? Why should that happen? Fair enough, why should it happen?
A new round has started.
Successful routing test. What a surprise. He might actually go ahead and kill us. Except we counterattack and kill him. He has one health point left. That almost sounds like a joke now. Now the Chaos Ogre still has the chance of maybe attacking one of my guys? No, he does not. Because we are going to shoot and kill Philip. Do we? Not from here? Should be from here, possible. We will shoot at him and kill him. We can reload various times. Once or maybe twice, but we have only one aimed shot left. Okay, let's say the Chaos Ogre will attack. That's fine. I don't care about you. Oh, he doesn't attack. That's also an option. Very odd, this guy. This Chaos Ogre is strange. Okay. Aldous will finish this. Aldous will have no problem killing him, right? There we go. Aldous will also have no problem hitting him a little bit. Very nice. That's what Theodore deserves. Actually, that's not true. I like the zombies in this game. But this round is just annoying. Actually, with these three crits, we kill him. We don't need to do anything even. We're still failing the terror test with him. That is annoying. Not going into defense stance, we'll just waste a little bit more time. And we've wasted sufficient on these guys. Another crit. That's almost now too much. Oh, I'm so sorry. Get in there. Off. And off the field you go. That was it, we killed all enemies. This Chaos Ogre. This Chaos Ogre, this match general. Pretty weird one. Well, we get nice crossbow pistols. We already have purple ones, but I don't think that we have any kind of enchantment on them, so we'll check that out as well.
Victory favors the just. It is Sigmar's will that you are triumphant this day.
Yeah, for sure, Sigmar's will was not involved in that, otherwise this would not have gone this way. Like, very, very strange. The Argus kill was odd, the Chaos Ogre was very weird guy, the stun on Reichwald was just annoying. All these things. Dietmar, I accept that he got knocked out. Amnesia, that I don't care about. Let's just see. Argus, also Amnesia, also doesn't matter. But very weird.
Is getting stronger.
We are level 9 with our warband, so one more reserve slot. Great, we get Fighting Claws, very useful. But we have a lot of Wordstone, quite good amount of money still. Just Light Wounds and Amnesia, that is totally fine. And let's give our guy some points. A little bit more in toughness and accuracy over here. And let's quickly check. Yeah, we have no enchantments, so why not giving him... because it doesn't matter. We don't have poison on our weapon, so it doesn't matter. You need a little bit more toughness. You got knocked out a little bit too quick for my liking. Actually, Ruben can equip the other ones. Maybe I will take him along as well at some point again. Quickly clicking around. There we go. He's the next one, a little bit more strength, and there's not much to choose from over there. And we are through. So I would like to thank you very much for watching. This round was extremely interesting. I hope to see you though in the next one as well. Bye for now.